In Thailand, it's a simple numbers game. In 2006, there were about 20 patrols a month in their tiger sanctuary, looking for poachers and recording the number of tigers and locations. Last year, there were 144 patrols a month. The result is that the recorded number of tigers jumped from about 40 in 2010 to close to 70 today.
In 2017, for example, there were ranger patrols doing about 4,000 kilometers of foot patrols every single month through the area. So to get this level of success, it actually is an enormous investment of time and money.
Elizabeth Bennett from the Wildlife Conservation Society says the Thai government is willing to make that investment in their tigers because they see the big cats as a source of national pride and tourist dollars. The tigers are part of a recently released list of 9 animals that have come back from the brink of extinction. Bennett says these kinds of success stories don't come easily and sometimes take decades and buy-in from local people to national governments.
Conservation, if we really work hard on it and we direct our efforts and our funding and our resources long-term in the right places and right ways, then we actually can save some of these species.
Species like humpback whales, which in some areas off the coast of Africa have bounced back to 70% of their pre-whaling numbers.
It's the end of whaling, and the International Whaling Commission and the end of whaling of these species, and they're recovering extremely nicely, and a lot of species are recovering, so which is extremely encouraging that, you know, even with something that's as slow breeding as a whale, if you take the primary pressure off, they can come back.
And jaguars. These cats have lost much of their habitat, but in some critical Wildlife Conservation Society-controlled areas, they are increasing in number.
And so one of the core things that has been very successful with a conservation program for jaguars is working with local ranchers and livestock herders to improve their husbandry practices. And basically, if you can corral the cattle at night, then jaguars will almost totally stop preying on them, and then the conflict disappears.
A few other species that are heading back from the brink, the American bison. In Guatemala, the scarlet macaw. And these tiny toads, once extinct in the wilds of Tanzania, now slowly being reintroduced into their unique environment in the spray of a nearby waterfall. Wildlife Conservation Society officials say it's proof that with determination and time, some of the world's most endangered species can come back. It's a bit of good news in an increasingly bleak biodiversity forecast. Kevin Enochs, VOA News.